Welcome to the National Science and Math Quiz.
Mauli, God with us.
In Deo Speramus, meaning in God is our hope.
Nothing but the best.
No precor, no meditor, ke no lucro. We pray, we practice, and we win.
Yes, Elijah.
It's false.
You're right. Yes, Gaddafi.
It's false.
Yes. Yes, Ama.
True.
Yes.
Root 2 times 10 upon negative 5 newtons, or 1.414 times 10 upon negative 5 newtons.
Yes, Jessica.
Condensation polymerization.
You're right. I am a property of matter. For some materials, I decrease when temperature is increased. Yes, Vanderpoel.
Density.
That's incorrect. Krempe College, that gives you 3 out of 10. Abebio.
Citric acid.
I'm not accepting that. I'm very disappointed. I'm giving every school 1 out of 10. Calm down, compose yourself, and deliver your answer clearly.
Good time to our reflection.
You are right. Yes, Jennifer.
Fermentation.
You are right. Yes, Jeremiah.
The streamline shape helps the fish to pass through the water without any problem.
University practice. Questions 1 to 4, all correct. I am happy to award a perfect score. Yes, Michael.
Solenoid.
Welcome to the National Science and Math Quiz. This is the third quarterfinal contest featuring Wesley Girls High School. GSTS. And Presbyterian Boys Senior High School. I have here with me Wesley Girls High School, represented by
Akosia Yabua Apiakubi, final year.
Ilham Salif for final year.
You are very welcome, ladies.
Thank you.
Wesley Girls High School, we saw you for the first time in the 1A stage competition, which featured Ola Senior High School and Kajabi Asatu Senior High School. In that contest, you waited until the last riddle to win. What can we expect from you today?
We expect God's will to be done today.
All right. Thank you and best wishes to you then. Next, we have GSTS, represented by
Edi Samuel Jojo, final year.
Kili Renok, final year.
You are very welcome, gentlemen. GSTS, at the 1A stage, you met with St. Paul Senior High School and Brekum Senior High School. That was not too bad, was it? No, because you won. What do we expect today?
We expect our best.
Your best?
Yeah.
All right. I wish you the best then. Finally, I have here with me Presbyterian Boys Senior High School Legon, represented by
Adams Joseph, final year.
Anum Julian, final year.
You are very welcome, gentlemen. Presbyterian Boys, you met with Swedro Senior High School and Bueman Senior High School at the 1A stage of competition. And you gave a very impressive performance. What are we expecting today?
In the light of Christ, we shall see light.
Anyway, best wishes to you. All right, the contestants are ready. I'm going to sit down so that we can begin. It's best I say nothing. May the best school win. Contestants, the contest comes to you in four rounds. The first round is a round for fundamental concepts. Simple, direct questions requiring simple, direct answers from you. If you answer your major question correctly, 3 points. If the question is incorrectly answered, it gets passed on. The two other schools can ring, and a correct answer at that stage fetches the bonus point. If the answer is incorrect, it fetches a penalty point. For questions that require calculations, you have 30 seconds to deliver an answer. If there are no calculations involved, you have 10 seconds to do so. All questions must be attempted once only. Best wishes to everyone. I'm going to start with you, Ghana Secondary Technical School, GSTS. Name any three metalloids in the first four periods of the periodic table. Kilu.
Silicon, germanium, boron, and indium.
I'm going to give you 2 out of 3. The reason being, I asked you for 3. Then you gave me 3 right ones and added the wrong one. Boron, silicon, germanium, and arsenic. But I wanted any 3 of those. Wesley girls, name the first 5 elements of group 2 of the periodic table in the right order. Yes, Akosua.
Beryllium, magnesium, calcium, strontium, barium.
You are right. Name all the elements in group 4 or 14 of the periodic table in the right order. Yes, Julian.
Carbon, silicon, germanium, tin, and lead.
You are right. The next question is a single one to all 3 schools. When I get to you, please give me a right answer. I move on for the next right answer. No bonus. This is the question. Name one, only one, of the cells or tissues that exhibit ciliary movements in the human body. GSTS, first choice. Yes, Kilu.
Cells of the fallopian tube.
All right. Elham.
The sperm cells.
Yes. Yes, Julian.
Cells of the nasal cavity.
I'm not accepting that. The cilia, present in the trachea of the lungs, beat in coordination to remove dust particles. 30 seconds and GSTS. Find the 8th term of a linear sequence with first term negative 3 and a common difference 5. Yes, Jojo.
32.
You're right. Find the 11th term of a linear sequence with first term 25 and common difference negative 2. Yes, Akosua.
5.
You're right. Find the 5th term of a linear sequence with first term 7 and common difference negative 3. Yes, Adams.
Negative 5.
You're right. <laughs> 30 seconds, this is your preamble. Preamble to all schools. The heat capacity of a thermally insulated quantity of water at 80 degrees Celsius is 4,000 joules per Kelvin. Find the final temperature when the given quantity of water at 40 degrees Celsius is added. GSTS, half the original amount. Yes, Jojo.
66.7 degrees Celsius.
Yes. Wesley girls, with the same preamble, twice the original amount. Yes, Akosua.
33.3 degrees Celsius.
That's incorrect. Yes, Jojo.
53.3 degrees Celsius.
All right. Presbyterian boys, equal amount. Yes, Julian.
60 degrees Celsius.
You're right. Define nuclear fission. Kilu.
It is the process by which a heavy atomic nucleus disintegrates into two approximately half or equal fragments with the release of energy and particles such as the alpha, beta, and gamma radiations.
Okay. Explain what a nuclear chain reaction is. Elham.
A nuclear chain fission reaction is one in which a fissionable material is bombarded with a neutron and then it disintegrates and then releases more neutrons to bombard other fissionable particles in order to let the reaction continue.
Okay. Presbyterian boys, what is a nuclear fission reactor? Yes, Julian.
Okay. A nuclear fission reactor is a device which produces electrical energy through the heat produced from the nuclear fission reactions. Through a controlled nuclear fission reaction.
I'll give you one. Yes, it's a device. It allows a controlled chain reaction of nuclear fission. So the chain reaction that was described, this device allows it to take place under controlled circumstances. Next set, it's a single question to all three schools. When I get to your school, please give me a right answer so I can move on for the next right answer. This is the question. Give one, only one, characteristic feature of root hair of plants. GSTS. Yes, Kilu.
They are one cell thick and have a large surface area to increase the absorption of water and mineral salt.
I'm not accepting that. Yes, Wesley girls. Yes, Akosua.
They have a thin cell wall and a narrow vacuole in between it to facilitate the absorption of water and mineral salts.
I'm not accepting it. Yes, Adams.
Okay, the root hair cells lack cuticle. They lack cuticle and they are able to absorb water from the soil. And also they are numerous and require the large surface area for absorption of water.
I'm not accepting it. I was looking for things like they are unicellular in nature. They don't branch or they are unbranched. The cell wall, by the way, is not a single layer. It's a double layer of cell wall. Outer layer, that's the pectin compounds, and inner layer, cellulose. Cell wall permeable to both solute and solvent. I didn't like the way you were telling me. They are tubular, colorless, and about 1 to 10 millimeters long. They are extensions of epidermal cells, that is the epiblema in the region of the absorption of the root. Do you see where I'm going? Uh-huh. Preamble to all schools. You are given the figures.
kite, rectangle, rhombus, trapezium, parallelogram. That's the preamble. Please, did you get it? All right, GSTS. In which of the figures are the opposite sides parallel? Yes, Jojo.
Madam, the rectangle, the rhombus, and the parallelogram.
You are right. Wesley girls, in which of the figures are the diagonals perpendicular? Yes, Akosua.
The rhombus, rectangle, and kite.
Two out of three. Is the kite and the rhombus, no rectangle. Presbyterian boys, in which of the figures do the diagonals bisect each other? Adams.
Rhombus and parallelogram and rectangle.
Yes. Next set, 30 seconds. GSTS. Find the work done when a 24 Newton force, which makes an angle of 30 degrees with the horizontal, moves an object horizontally through a distance of 5 meters. Yes, Jojo.
60 with 3 Newtons.
That's incorrect. Yes, Akosua.
60 with 3 joules.
That's right. Find the work done when a 100 Newton force, which makes an angle of 60 degrees with the horizontal, moves an object horizontally through a distance of 8 meters. Yes, Akosua.
400 joules.
You're right. Find the work done when a 40 Newton force, which makes an angle of 45 degrees with the horizontal, moves an object horizontally through a distance of 2 meters. Yes, Adams.
40 with 2 joules.
You're right. Preamble to all schools. Pick the odd ones out and give your reasons. The reasons are important. Pick the odd ones out and give your reasons. That's the preamble. GSTS. Carbohydrates, proteins, nylon, and lipids. Kilu, is your hand up? Go ahead.
Madam, nylon, because all the others are natural polymers. And nylon is a synthetic polymer.
Yes. With the same preamble, ethyl propanoate, ethanoic acid, butanoyl chloride, and methanamide. Akosua.
Please, is the ethanoic acid, because it's the only acid. The rest are salts and a base.
I'm not accepting that. Bonus. It's ethanoic acid. It is an alkanoic acid. The rest are acid derivatives. Presbyterian boys, with the same preamble, tetradecanoic acid, hexadecanoic acid, heptadecanoic acid, and octadecanoic acid. Yes, Adams?
It's tetradecanoic acid. This is because they are all fatty acids except the tetradecanoic acid.
That's incorrect. For a bonus. It's the heptadecanoic acid. It has an odd number of carbons and cannot be obtained from hydrolysis of vegetable oils and fats. The rest have even number of carbons and can be obtained from vegetable oils and fats. Next is a single question to all three schools. I come to your school, give me a right answer, I move on to the next school for the next right answer. This is the question. State one, only one difference between a grazing food chain and a detritus food chain. It's your hand up, Kilu, go ahead.
The grazing involves living organisms, such as the use of living grass, but the detritus involves the use of dead compost or fallow compost.
Yes. Elham.
The grazing has plants as the main producers or the starters of the food chain, but the detritus have decaying organic matter as the starts of the food chain.
That's not different. So I'm moving on. Presbyterian boys. Yes, Julian.
Okay, in the grazing food chain, the primary consumer is a herbivore, whereas in the detritus food chain, the primary consumer is a detritivore.
I'm not accepting that. This is what I was expecting. A much less fraction of energy flows through grazing food chain, whereas a much larger fraction of energy flows through this detritus food chain. So less energy for grazing, more energy for detritus. Addition to that, grazing food chain binds inorganic nutrients, but detritivore food chain releases inorganic nutrients, bound in organic matter. Finally, the grazing food chain is directly dependent on the inflow of solar radiation, whereas the detritivore does not come from the organic, does not require the sun directly. All right, so these were the sort of answers I was looking for. Solve the radical equation, that's the preamble. GSTS. Square root of the expression x plus 4 is equal to 3. It's your hand up, Kilu. Go ahead.
Madam, 5.
Yes. With the same preamble. Square root of the expression 2x minus 1 is equal to 7. Akosua,
x is equal to 24.
That's incorrect. Yes, Adams.
X equal to 25.
Yes. Your major question, with the same preamble. Square root of the expression 3x minus 5 is equal to 11. Yes, Adams.
X equal to 42.
Yes. A 0.5 kilogram object is whirled at the end of a 2 meter string in a vertical circle. Find the tension in the string when the object is at the bottom of the circle and it is moving with the given speed. Acceleration due to gravity is approximately 10 meters per second squared. Please, did you get your preamble? All right, GSTS, 2 meters per second. Jojo?
6 newtons.
You're right. With the same preamble, 5 meters per second. Yes, Alam?
25 newtons.
That's incorrect. Yes. Jojo?
7.5 newtons.
That's incorrect. The right answer is 11.25 newtons. With the same preamble, 4 meters per second. Yes, Adams?
9 newtons.
You're right. GSTS, by the way, next set is 30 seconds. GSTS, state the type of segmentation possessed by tapeworms. For a bonus. Pseudo-segmentation. Wesley girls. Name the cylindrate that does not have a medusa stage. Akosua?
The jellyfish.
That's incorrect. For a bonus. It's the hydra. Name the phylum of organisms that possesses the hemocell. Yes, Adams?
Phylum Arthropoda.
You're right. Seconds with a preamble to all schools. Two fair dice are thrown. Find the probability. That's the preamble. GSTS. The total score is 10. Yes, Adams.
1 out of 12.
Yes. With the same preamble, the total score is less than 5. Akosua?
1/6.
You're right. The total score exceeds 10. Yes, Adams?
1 out of 12.
You're right. Last set of questions for the round. You have 30 seconds, and this is the preamble. The Coulomb constant is approximately 9.0 times 10 raised to the power 9 meters per farad. Did you get your preamble? All right. GSTS. Find the electric potential midway between two point charges, 5 microcoulomb and negative 5 microcoulomb that are 0.2 meters apart. Yes, Jojo.
4 times 10 to the power 5 volts.
That's incorrect. For a bonus. The right answer is 0. With the same preamble, Wesley girls, find the electric potential midway between two point charges, 5 microcoulomb and 5 microcoulomb that are 0.2 meters apart. Yes, Alam.
9.0 times 10 exponent 4.
That's incorrect. For a bonus. The right answer is 900 kilovolts or 9.0 times 10 to the power 5 volts. With the same preamble, find the electric potential midway between two point charges, negative 1 microcoulomb and negative 1 microcoulomb that are 0.2 meters apart. Yes, Adams?
1.8 times 10 to the power 5 volts. 1.8
That's
times.
Incorrect for a bonus.
Nice.
The right answer is negative 180 kilovolts or negative 1.8 times 10 to the power 5 volts. Negative sign. That's the end of the first round. At the end of the first round, Wesley Girls High School has 21 points. GSTS has 29 points. Presbyterian Boys Senior High School Legon has 33 points. Well done, more work to do. Round two. In this round, I'm going to present a single question to all three schools, the problem of the day. From the time I ask you to begin, you have 3 minutes to present a single answer from your school. The problem of the day is worth 10 points. Now let's turn over our sheets and read the problem of the day together. Problem of the day. The activity of a radioactive substance is measured every 200 seconds by means of a Geiger counter. The results are as follows, and I have a table. Time. And count. So for time, 0 seconds, I have 1,600. For time, 200 seconds, I have 802 counts. For 400 seconds, I have 399 counts. For 600 seconds, I have 205 counts. A, estimate the error in the initial count. B, determine the initial count rate if counting is done for 10 seconds. C, determine the half-life of the substance. And D, determine the activity of a sample of the substance containing 10 to the power 6 active nuclei. Contestants, this is your problem of the day. You may now begin. Writing and present your answers. Contestants, please pick up your answers and present them on the boards. Contestants have presented their answers. Before we award the marks, let's look at the suggested solution from the consultants. This is a problem in physics. It's a practical one. So the activity of a radioactive substance is measured every 200 seconds by use of a Geiger counter, and the results have been given. So we have time, let it be T in seconds, and then we have count, let it be N. So we have the data given, 0, 200, 400, 600 seconds, and then we have 1,600, 802, 399, 205. The first question is to estimate the error in the initial count. So we go to the initial one, that is the one at time t equals 0. The count is 1,600. If you want to find the error, if you want to estimate the error in this initial count, you simply take the square root of the value. So you have square root of 1,600 to give you 42 points. Next, determine the initial count rate if counting is done for 10 seconds. So that measurement was taken over a 10-second period, and the measurement is actually 1,600 counts. So if you want to get the count rate, it's 1,600 counts divided by 10 seconds. This gives 160 counts per second, 2 points. Third, determine the half-life of the substance. This one can be determined just by looking, carefully looking at the data there. So you see, if you look carefully, that the activity is decreasing by half every 200 seconds. Look at the measurements. Within the limits of the error, it decreases by half every 200 seconds. So the half-life is simply 200 seconds. 3 points. Finally, determine the activity of a sample of the substance containing 10 to the power 6 active nuclei. Activity is given by lambda multiplied by number of counts. This is 0.693 N over half-life. So we have 0.693 times 10 to the power 6 divided by 200 seconds to give 3,465 becquerels. 3 points, giving a total of 10 points. This is the suggested solution from the consultants. Now, contestants, Wesley Girls High School, this was a real problem for you. I'm giving you 1 out of 10. Presbyterian boys, you did not understand our problem of the day. 1 out of 10. GSTS, you also had trouble with this. You couldn't do A, you couldn't do B, you couldn't do D. But C, the half-life, you were able to do. So that gives you 3 points. And since I gave 1 point to this, I'm going to add one more to give 4 out of 10. That's the end of the problem of the day and the end of round two. You may pick up your notepads. Round three. In this round, I'm going to present you with statements. When you receive your statement, please consider the statement carefully and let me know whether it's true or false. If you are right, 2 points. If you are incorrect, you lose a precious point. You may choose not to respond, in which case that statement becomes available to the two other schools. When a school ranks and answers correctly, 2 full points. If the answer is incorrect, it fetches the penalty point. Now, for this round, your business is with me. Please, look in this direction. All right. Best wishes to all schools. I'm starting with you, Wesley Girls. The power factor for an alternating current circuit that contains only resistors is unity. Akosua?
True.
You're right. An ideal inductor in an alternating current circuit dissipates the same power as a resistor whose resistance equals the reactance of the inductor. Adams.
It's false.
You're right. The power factor for an ideal capacitor is zero. Jojo.
False.
No, that's a true statement. In the Cartesian plane, that's the preamble. The lines X is equal to 2 and Y is equal to 2 are perpendicular. Akosua?
True.
Yes. The lines X is equal to 5 and X is equal to negative 5 are parallel. Yes, Adams?
It's true.
Yes. The lines X plus Y is equal to 1 and X minus Y is equal to 1 are perpendicular. Kilu?
False.
Oh. That's a true statement. The major forces that keep proteins in their alpha helix structure are covalent bonds. Yes, Julian.
It's false.
You're right. Your major statement. The intermolecular forces in liquid bromine are dipole-dipole. Yes, Julian.
It's false.
You're right. In cellulose, the forces that hold several glucose polymer chains together are hydrogen bonding. Kilu.
Madam Chu.
Yes. Most animals digest food intracellularly. Yes, Akosua.
True.
No. That's a false statement. Cells lining the gut of animals take in some small food particles by endocytosis. Julian.
It's false.
No, that's a true statement. Some multicellular organisms have no digestive system. Jojo.
Madam Force.
Oh. The dependence of the focal length of a lens on wavelength arises because refractive index depends on wavelength. Yes, Akosua.
False.
Oh. Chromatic aberration in a spherical lens results in a blurred image because light rays passing through the lens at different distances from the pole are brought to focus at different points. Adams.
It's true.
No. GSTS. Chromatic aberration is not observed in the images formed by curved mirrors. Jojo.
True.
You are right. For the next set, I have a short preamble. Preamble. A and B are polynomial expressions. That's the preamble. Wesley girls. If AB is equal to 0, then A is equal to 0. Yes, Elham.
False.
You are right. With the same preamble, if A over B is undefined, then B is equal to 0. Julian.
It's true.
You are right. With the same preamble, if A over B is equal to 0, then A is equal to 0. Kilu.
True.
Yes. On adding dilute HCl to sodium sulfide, a gas that decolorizes acidified KMnO4 solution is given out. Yes, Akosua.
False.
No. That's a true statement. On adding dilute H2SO4 to sodium trioxosulfate-4 solution, a solution that decolorizes acidified KMnO4 is given out. Julian.
It's true.
Yes. On adding AgNO3 solution to a solution, the formation of a solid that does not dissolve in dilute HNO3 but dissolves in ammonia solution indicates the presence of chloride in the solution. Yes, Kilu.
True.
You're right. Last set of statements. red algae differ from other algal forms in lacking flagellated reproductive cells? Yes, Akosua.
False.
No. The red algae and brown algae are predominantly unicellular. Julian.
It's false.
Yes. In some algae, both haploid and diploid cells undergo mitosis. Yes, Jojo.
Madam Force.
Oh. That's the end of the third round. At the end of the third round, Wesley Girls High School has 24 points. GSTS has 37 points. Presbyterian Boys Senior High School Legon has 46 points. Final round, round four. In this round, I'm going to be reading out clues. Your objective is to solve the riddle. If you solve the riddle on the first clue, 5 points. On the second clue, 4 points. On the third clue, or any other clue thereafter, 3 points. In order to solve a riddle, you need to draw my attention. You do that by ringing your bell. May I hear your bell, Wesley Girls High School? Thank you. Yours, GSTS. And yours, Presbyterian Boys. Thank you. When you ring, the answer must be ready. There are four riddles. In my natural state, I am gaseous, made up of two different elements. I have two pi bonds in my molecule. In my pure form, I am colorless and odorless. I am relatively nonpolar because of my structure. Yes, Akosua?
CO2.
You're right. That was the fourth clue, 3 points. Next riddle. I am a principle that describes the behavior of fluids. I am responsible for operation of hydraulic machines.
Pascal's principle.
Yes. I have different types. I may be considered natural, whole, positive, or negative.
Numbers.
No. Yes, Akosua.
Integers.
No. GSTS, for you. I may be considered natural, whole, positive, or negative. I am the basic building block of mathematics. I am often considered reasonable or rational, as well as crazy or irrational. I may be terminating or repeating. You can locate me on a line bearing my name. So who am I? Yes, Kilu.
Real number system.
The right answer is real number. Simple real number. Last riddle. I was born to a Catholic family of a poor tanner. I lived at the time when microbiology was the subject of controversy. I was an average student in my early years and not particularly academic, as my interests were fishing and sketching. Although I made groundbreaking experiments, my reputation became associated with various controversies. I established that fermentation is the result of microbial activity. Yes, Akosua.
Louis Pasteur.
You are right. That was the last clue, 3 points, and that's the end of the fourth round. At the end of the contest, here are the final scores. Wesley Girls High School has 30 points. GSTS has 37 points. Presbyterian Boys Senior High School Legon has 49 points. Wesley Girls High School, thank you for being here. Best wishes to you. GSTS, thank you for being here also. All the best. Presbyterian Boys, congratulations on winning the contest. Well done. Prepare well, especially true or false. And I look forward to seeing you in the semifinals. Viewers, thank you for joining us for this contest. Next time, we'll bring you the fourth quarterfinal contest featuring St. Peter Senior High School, Accra Academy, and Kintampo Senior High School. Thank you and see you next time. Bye.